Look around and carefully observe your surroundings. You would see a lot of triangles around. In fact, if you observe a bridge or if you go to a construction site, it would be pretty easy to spot triangles there. Why is it that triangles are used? Is there some specific reason or just generally? Well, you would have an answer to this by the end of this lecture. Let's first look at this. So a teacher asks students to make triangles of sides 4, 5 and 6 centimeter. So this is what the students had drawn, some of the drawings. Can you say that these triangles are congruent? When would the triangles be congruent? When the sides and angles are congruent, the triangles are also congruent. We know that the sides are congruent because all triangles have the same sides. What about angles? That is my concern. Are the angles congruent? But before I go to that, let us just look that these two figures, let's observe, these two figures are nothing but mirror reflections of each other. So this is a mirror reflection of this along a vertical mirror. If you observe this image, then this is a mirror reflection about a horizontal mirror. This is a rotation. If I rotate this image clockwise, I would get something like this if I rotate it clockwise. Rotating this anti-clockwise, I would get something like this. So basically, each of this is nothing but a rotation or a reflection of this image. Hence, I can say that they're all congruent because rotations and reflections give me congruent images. But just to verify, I measure all the angles and I see that the corresponding angles are also congruent. Hence, whenever I have three sides of one triangle equal to three sides of the other triangle, I can say that the triangles will be congruent. So now can you tell me whether these two triangles will be congruent or not? Well, we see that they will be congruent if three sides of one would be equal to three sides of the other triangle. So here the sides of the triangle are 5, 5 and 7. What about here? Again, the sides are 5, 5 and 7. Since three sides of this triangle are equal to the three sides of this triangle, I can say that these triangles are congruent. In fact, whenever you're asked to check whether the triangles are congruent or not, and you're given three pair of sides, it is sufficient to say that the triangles will be congruent, and I call this the SSS rule, which is the side, side, side rule. So three sides if given are equal to the three sides of another triangle, I can say they are congruent by SSS. Now let us look at this. Say there was an earthquake that cracked the wall. Now you want to prevent this door from collapsing. What can you do? This door is unstable because it has four sides and these four sides can take different shapes. Let us see how. So if you apply pressure, then these four sides can take different shapes. But if I put a diagonal across it, then what do you see? It does not move. This becomes stable. So this door can be prevented from collapsing by putting a diagonal brace. Why does this diagonal brace make it more stable? Why is this unstable whereas this is stable? This is unstable because we've seen it take different shapes. But as soon as I put a diagonal brace along this door, what I'm doing is I'm actually forming two triangles. And these two triangles have three sides fixed by SSS congruency, which is the side, side, side congruency. I know that as soon as I fix the three sides of a triangle, I can get only one possible shape and size. That is the congruent triangle. So the shape and size does not move, so the triangle becomes rigid. Fixing three sides of a triangle makes it a congruent triangle. It cannot have any other possible shape and size, and that makes the triangle rigid. It cannot distort. Now you would know why exactly triangles are used. So triangles are used in bridges or constructions of buildings because it adds strength to the structure. So now, what the teacher does is, she asks students to make triangles with three different angles. She now assigns 30 degrees, 60 degrees and 90 degrees as three angles and asks them to make different triangles. So this is what the students, some of the students had drawn. So now can you say that these triangles are congruent? What do we need? Same angles, same sides. Angles are fixed. What do I need to worry about is sides. Are the sides the same? Well, clearly you can see a difference in size of the sides. So I cannot say they are congruent. So three angles may or may not give me congruent images. So they are not congruent because the sides are not the same. They need not be congruent. So if three angles are given to me, I cannot definitely say that the triangles will not be congruent. They may be congruent. Here the size looks the same. Whereas here the size is different. They may or may not be congruent. So what you need to take away from this lecture is that if two triangles are congruent, if two triangles have same three sides, then I can say that they are congruent by side, side, side. And if the three angles are the same, the triangles need not be congruent.